Hallelujah. All right, let's take our prayer for the week. The book of Genesis chapter 13, verse 14. One verse of scripture. Genesis 1:3, 1:4. Genesis 1:3, 1:4. And the Lord said unto Abram, after that Lot was separated from him, lift up now thine eyes and look from the place where thou art, northward, eastward, and southward, and westward. Now look up. Now the Bible says, and God spoke to Abraham after Lot had departed. Now I told us one time when I was talking on tearing the veil that Lot speaks of a veil. Is that true? Now when you talk about a veil, this man had God after the veil was torn. Now I thought that a veil only speaks of a facial covering. When you say someone has a veil, it means there is a facial covering. But the voice of God was not audible until the veil was torn. So that means a veil could also mean what covers your audibility. So the veil is not only a facial covering, it can also be that which covers your hearing God. So Lot left, and as soon as you watch the story of Lot in the first place, God never told Abraham to go with Lot. Abraham took Lot. Excess what? Luggage or garbage. And I told them, I think, what was that? I can't remember the country. I said, if you must travel far, you must travel light. And the problem, there are lots of excess luggage we are carrying that are of no profit to us, but we just carry them for the sake of emotion. You will pray this prayer. Any veil that is standing as an impediment to the audibility of God's voice, today I tear you out of my life. Out of my life. Hello? Let me say this to you. I've discovered that most of the things we attach very, very strong importance to are of no consequence. There are certain things God will not do for you until certain people leave you. Pray, fast, intercede, it cannot happen. You know, I grew up to hear a word that there is no smoke without fire. But it was in Christianity, I know there can be smoke without fire. Satan can generate a smoke that has no fire. But it is you from your mind that will now make up the fire. It is you from your mind that will make up the fire. But what I'm saying is that we are going to pray. Whatever veil, you need to hear God. What makes you in demand is when you hear his command. Only men that hear God deliver response in their generation. Every veil preventing your debility. Because if you are stuck in life, you are stuck. You don't know the next step to take. At that point, what you need urgently is the voice of God. Anytime you get to a point where you are stuck, you need the voice. Because when he speaks, he shall speak peace. Now, he's not going to just come and say peace. It means what he will tell you will generate peace. What he will tell you will culminate in peace. Lift up your right hand. Say, in the name of Jesus, every veil. Are you praying? I told you when you make this declaration, you switch into the Holy Ghost. Switch into tongues. Any believer that prays in his understanding has a problem. Because the Holy Ghost knows the dimension more than you. Say, every veil standing as an impediment to the audibility of God's voice in my life, I tear you down. Open your mouth and pray in the Holy Ghost. I must hear your voice. Barikose, raka bala shoot. La calalasho, la casolero, recasolero. Determines your flight. How far you see determines how high you fly. What seest thou? Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 5. I've seen an almond tree, for if thou hast seen well, I will hasten my word to perform it. Meaning your sight determines your speed. Thou hast seen well, I will hasten my word. You don't need to be a prophet to be a seer. Every believer should be a seer. Don't say, am I in the prophetic? No, sir. If you are a child of God, you must see something. Why the Bible calls us eagles is because of the power of sight. What makes the eagle different from other birds is that the eagle can see far. So if you are a blind eagle, you are not better than a vulture. Because take away sight, every other duties of the ego, the vulture performs. The ego devours, the vulture devours. Is that true? So a blind ego is equal to what? Open my eyes. Listen, most of the things we have seen done cheaply in this ministry is a function of sight. I was praying, I saw a 70,000 seater, and I said to God, by then we're having several overflows in church. I said, Lord, where is that? He says, behind. I said, behind, where, how? He says, behind. I said, where, how? 70,000, how? And he showed me. When we started, we were trying to do a block walk. And the Holy Ghost spoke to me clearly. Again, he showed me. He said, the ministry you have is not a ministry for block walk. It's not a ministry for structure. It's a tent. It's an old-time revival ministry. If you check the revival of the 70s, of the 60s, 50s, it was tents. And God told me, he said, the crowd coming, a structure can't carry them. He said, just make it plain and keep breaking. I was praying one time, while this construction was going on, I was praying one time, and I saw a massive auditorium that was sitting a million people. And I said, Lord, are you sure? Say no. After this phase, that is the next phase. So if you are going around this place now, you are seeing structures everywhere, and you are shouting. It means when you see where you are going, your head cannot contain it. Now, what am I working on? I'm working on the premise of what I saw. There are some services, before I come here, I watch them. I can just sit down and see what happened. So when I just come in there, I just start following what I saw, and they just fall in place. Mama and I, we have been abroad sometimes. I'll tell her, I said, in that meeting, somebody will be like this. There'll be somebody like this. The person will be sitting there in so-so place. There also, I'll tell her. By the time we get there, when I start ministering to them, she'll just start laughing. She'll start laughing. Go say, I say, I saw it. I saw it. What can you see? Hold on. First of all, if you must see what you can't see in God's word, you can't see in the spirit. I told you one nation we went to one time, and my passport was full. We've been preaching back to back. Last year, we were in about 30 countries, so there was no time for me to even go and renew my passport. And I was at the foot of the aircraft, about to board. When they were doing the final check, they looked. They said, sorry, you cannot fly. I said, why? They said, your passport is full. Number one, we don't know even allowed you from the immigration. You have a full passport. On arrival at the country, no space to even stamp you out. I said, I don't know, I'm here already. Our Lagos pastor was talking to them, Pastor Henry. He was trying to talk to the people. I turned my back because I remember when Ezekiah had issues. At that point, your confrontation should only see your back. So I turned my back and I began to do what I know how to do. I began to pray in the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost said to me, you will fly. I told the man, I said, no problem. If you say the country will return me, let the country return me. Just let me leave Nigeria. He said, fine. We left. I was in the plane. As I sat in the plane, the Holy Spirit said to me, whatever you cannot see in scripture, you can't see in picture. Look for a scripture that matters to this present challenge. And I began to scan the Bible. Like a man about to write an exam. And I found Psalm 115. As they move from nation to nation, he suffered no man to do them wrong. He reproved king for their sake, saying, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. And I turned and I told them, Fidelis, I said, I found it. As we landed, I said, I'm going to cross. He said, what? I said, I will cross. I found it. And I showed him and he started running around. He was jumping. As soon as we got to that country, because we did the transit, when we got to that country, I was walking, speaking in tongues, holding that scripture as they move from nation to nation. I have left my nation now to another nation. He suffered no man to do them wrong. No man can do me wrong. Reproof king for their sake. As soon as I was coming in, a lady, she was not even at the immigration stand. She was sitting somewhere. She looked. Myself, Pastor Henry, and Philip, he looked at me, he said, Pastor, he said, come. We moved to our office, not the immigration side. We walked there. He said, what's the matter? We said, nothing. We just came in. He said, bring your passport. He opened all my passport page full. He said, you need a visa on arrival in this country. I said, but my passport is full and I'm here. He said, hey, okay. Hi, what do I do? He brought the visa stamp and stamped a visa on an existing visa. That does not happen anywhere in the world. On an existing visa. I said, thank you. No excitement. I've already located. And they stamped their visas and they were looking at me. We walked out. While we are coming back now, there would have been issues. Who stamped you in? As we are coming back, we met the same lady. She said, hey, they told me what happened. So you are the man of God that they told. The whole country is upside down. You are leaving, say yes. She knelt down. He said, pray for me. I prayed for her and she stamped me out. He said, bye bye. When I landed my country, they were opening my passport. Open up, say, how did you go and come? This thing is full. I say, I'm in my country now. Don't try yourself. I'm here already now. Oh Lord, open my eyes. Speak. Do you know blindness is what makes you employ an assassin as a driver? Blindness is what makes a man have a marine spirit agent as a house help. Spiritual blindness. I told you, Jesus, God could not begin creation until there was light. You will pray. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my
every
Father.
Veil covering my spiritual eyes.
Every veil covering my spiritual eyes.
Take them up by the Holy Ghost.
Take them up by the Holy,
take them up by the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth and pray. Every veil covering my spiritual eyes. Every veil preventing me from seeing well. Le barakatolo soya. Le kaparayalaka. Le potati. Le potati. La baraka solararata. Shayala. In Jesus' name. Just worship him, worship the King of Kings. A song for the month is one of the songs I wrote. Lift your hands. Worship him. Mo la 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 la.
Yata da da yata la 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 la. Ziga la 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 la. Worship the Lamb of God. Zigilegilegile. I will sing to the Lord of my life and my soul, the one who died for me. Ebenezer, Jehovah helps me. He will hear my call.
Ebenezer, Jehovah.
Oh, Ebenezer. Jehovah sees, he wipes my tears,
the rest of my years.
Ebenezer, Jehovah helps. Oh, Ebenezer, Jehovah helps. Ebenezer, Jehovah sees,
Jehovah sees,
he wipes my tears, he restores my years.
Ebenezer,
oh, Ebenezer,
Ebenezer,
Jehovah hears. Oh, Ebenezer,
Ebenezer,
Jehovah sees.
He wipes my tears,
he restores my years.
Ebenezer,
one more time. Lift your hands to him. His name is Jesus. And you are Jesus. You are Jesus. And there is something about your name.
Yeah.
every single soul by your power and by your spirit.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Give the Lord a hand of praise as you take your seat. Hallelujah. We want to appreciate Jesus for what we've been seeing from January, as a matter of fact, from December, the last week of December, all through January, at all the states we've been in the country, and we just started international. It's been awesome. God is so good. And how many of you watched Johannesburg live? You watched it live. How many of you watched it live? Amen. And that's the faithfulness of God. Every growth, astronomical growth we see as a ministry around the world, it will reflect in your life. That amen is offending my anointing. Revelation chapter 5, verse 12, we started last week on a series on the benefit of the blood. Is that what I started last week? Revelation chapter 5 and verse 12, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power, riches, wisdom, strength, and honor, glory, and blessing. And I started the teaching last week, and I said, there is a religious application of the blood that has undermined the efficacy of the blood. I grew up to meet a certain religious group who, as far as I'm concerned, they are religious enchanters and charlatans. Who, at the sight of a disaster, they call the blood. There's about to be an accident, the blood. So I met religious enchanters who only think that the blood, the place of the blood, is the place of defense. As if the blood is a defense mechanism, or the blood is an application that wards off evil. And I began to explain to us that when you see the blood of Jesus as only a defense mechanism, you are underusing the blood. The Bible says, he cried with a loud voice saying, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. In other words, what gave the angel a voice was because the Lamb was slain. And I explained to us that when you understand the power of the blood, you must be announced. What he cried with a loud voice. And I explained to us that when you become born again, redemption is not reduction. You are not saved to reduce. You must carry a mentality. How come when people fail exam in school, they say it's because they went to fellowship? When they fail exam, they say it's because they are Christians. When you are looking for people who are doing well in a class, it's so shameful that among the first three, you don't see Christian. Who is the richest man in Africa? Not a believer. It's an abuse. But how did he become rich? He became a rich man by appreciating grace. The richest man today in Africa deals on sugar, indomie, cement. How did he become rich? He traced his story to 1991, when the late Archbishop had two visitors from America, and the visitors needed to fly, and the plane was about taking off. The Archbishop told the people at the counter, I have two visitors, they need to connect a flight to America. And they say, well, there's nothing you can do, the plane is full. He said, can I just walk straight and talk to the passengers? They said, what do you mean? And someone said, let the Archbishop go. The pilot said, let him go. And the Archbishop said, please. He told every one of them, I have two guests who must fly to America tonight. I need two people to come down. Please. And this man then was just a frustrated businessman in Kano. He was flying with his PA. And he looked at his PA and said, please, let's come down. This is a man of God. There were Christians in that aircraft. And he came down and the Archbishop said to him, for standing up for me, Africa will stand up for you. And many years later, for the past 5 years, he has been the wealthiest man in Africa, continuously, steadily, steady rise in Forbes. Whatever he loses, he gains double. Why? It was a prophetic covenant that was speaking for him. Some people were there, but they were too familiar with that covenant. They're too familiar with that grace. And I've told you that familiarity brings familiar spirit. You must understand that as a Christian, you are not an enchanter. You are a covenant practitioner. Jesus, Jesus. You see somebody who has not paid tithe. Problem. Jesus. He's not giving offering. Jesus. Little problem. Jesus. And
And he expects you to walk. You think these things for rabble rousers? A young man saw me lay on the sick, he said, rise up and walk. Cripple, rise up. Blind, see. He called me. He said, Apostle, one problem I have is that the ease, if you have watched Jehovah the Doctor in Johannesburg, you'd have seen three sessions. And you see miracles. He said to me, we know what they call. This thing, you have to worship, you lay hands. And I said to him, it's a function of grace, true covenant. The blood! You saw what the blood means? He said, to bring power, riches, wisdom, strength, honor, glory, blessing. So when you say the blood, seven virtues show up. Not defense. You're underusing the blood. Some people will carry water. It's bottled water. They say this is the blood of Jesus. But water. Say it's the blood of Jesus. Take, drink the blood. Drink. Drink the blood. Someone says, I drink. That's initiation. You are drinking blood. You are a vampire. Are drinking blood. When you do not know the depth of a virtue, you underutilize it. Tell your neighbor, when you don't know the depth of a virtue, you underutilize it. And I started, I told us that the blood of the first thing it does, it gives us power. Somebody shall power. I explained that last week and I said what this generation is looking for is power. It's power. What this generation is looking for is power. And I said to you, power speaks of manifestation and power in government speaks of influence. Influence. Power. And that is why it would be shameful if your boss in the office is not a believer, because I said your boss in the office determines your mood. He can make you cry this instant. Just one query, your mood can change. I said, why don't you own the company so you can determine people's mood? Influence. Why don't you own the company? With all due respect, I must say this. I'm not comfortable when a believer is working for an unbeliever. They will fault your Christian service. They will fault your Christian service. They will fault everything. Why? You need influence in the church. What prayer cannot do, influence can do. When Jesus died, his body was not given to prayer warriors. It was given to Joseph of Arimathea, a man in government, a man of influence. The disciples said, we want the body. They said, get out of here. But a man who was in power, he said, I want the body. Influence. Receive influence in your life. My God, receive men of influence, women of influence, people of power. Lift your voice, shout, I receive influence. Shout again. Shout again. Number two, riches. And I said to you that God is a spiritual God, but he created a material world. You know, I told you, I said, listen, killing demons, fighting witchcraft and all is good, but all of that happens when your obedience is fulfilled. There's a dimension you operate. When he said, the Lord said to my Lord, rule down in the midst of your enemies. Where your enemies are just around, but to you, they are not existing because they are too inconsequential. If there is anything the devil hates, deprive him of attention. Riches. Money will enter your hand. What we are seeing here happen. And in the midst of this, God will lead me to buy cars for people. God will lead me to give people millions of naira. We are not bothered. Why? We have a covenant that so long the earth remaineth, see time. You are blaming Muslims. They are not your problem. Meet a Muslim and say, Baraka the Salah. He puts hand in his babariga. He says, Zomana. He gives you money. Tell a Christian, Happy Christmas. Same to you. True. I was in South Africa and I was blessing lives, giving like a madman. Am I talking to somebody? Giving. Why? That is the key to being blessed. Somebody shout the benefits of the blood. I want to go further on that this morning. When Jesus came, Jesus did miracles. The veil was not removed. He opened blind eyes. The veil was not removed.
He made the lame walk.
The veil was not removed.
He brought Lazarus back to life after 4 days.
The veil was not removed.
He looked at a man who was a leper. The man said, if thou will make me clean. He said, I will. The veil was not removed. But as soon as he was on that cross and the blood touched the earth, the Bible said the veil was torn. Meaning the blood is beyond miracles. The blood is beyond sign. The blood has a life of its own. There are veils in your life that needs to be torn. I am here today to appropriate the blood. And I'm speaking to your life, speaking to all that concerns you. By the mystery of the blood, every veil around you that has covered your potential, that has covered your talent, that has covered your idea, that has covered your innovation, by the power of the blood, the veil shall be torn. The veil shall be torn. Lift your voice, shout, tear the veil.
Sit down if you can. Genesis chapter 4. When Abel died. Look at this. Let me give you a revelation. When Abel died. Huh? Can I go on? God said to Cain. Genesis 4 from verse 9. He said, where is thy brother Abel? How did God know? His blood.
Cry it!
For as soon as the blood started crying, God started cursing Cain. God did not ask what happened though. When the blood is around, God does not look for the source of the quarrel. And the Lord said, where is Cain thy brother? Where is Abel thy brother? And Cain said, am I my brother's keeper? And God said, verse 10, for the blood of thy brother crieth from the ground unto me. He said, you are cursed. A fugitive and a vagabond. You know what vagabond is? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he said you shall be yeyeshus and mumushus. Yeah, 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 yeah. There are people you cannot define. You can't say they are poor. You can't say they are sick. They are what? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Am I talking? Say,
when thou tillest the ground, it shall not henceforth yield to thee as strength. A fugitive.
And in other words, you'll be a stranger to the earth. What was talking? The blood. Now watch this.
The blood of Abel speaks revenge and yet cost somebody.
The blood of Abel only was speaking revenge.
And yet, by reason of that blood, God got so angry.
I don't know if I'm preaching here. God did not ask what happened. As soon as the blood cried out, God said, huh?
The blood
of thy brother. Can I say this to you? Can I say this to you? By the power of the Holy Ghost, as we appropriate the blood, there are things that have been out of place in your life, they will fall in line in the name of Jesus.
The blood!
Sit down. Now, if that blood spoke revenge, keep that your Bible from Genesis and run through to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 24. Hear what the Bible says, that the blood of Jesus speaketh, Hebrews 12, 24,
better things,
plural. Things, those are the things that were revealed in Revelation chapter 5, the things, than the blood of Abel. Abel's blood spoke revenge, but the blood of Jesus speak better things.
Ah,
it speaks. It's a speaking blood. Number one, it spoke power. Number two, riches. And number three, it said
wisdom.
It spoke wisdom. Somebody shout wisdom. What is wisdom? People have said wisdom is the right application of knowledge. But my definition of wisdom, simply put, wisdom is locating God's way of doing things. Locating God's method of doing things.
Wisdom. Anytime
you discover you are becoming stupid, you're running to mental bankruptcy, lay your hands on your head, say, the blood of Jesus.
Wisdom shows up. You have a child and a daughter.
that is 29 and behaving 19. Lay hands and impart sufficient blood on that head. Put blood and mass. The blood.
The wisdom.
Locating God's way. Can I shock you? The wisest are always the wealthiest. What made Solomon stand out in his generation? Wisdom. God said, for asking for wisdom, he said, because thou have not asked for wisdom, nor riches, nor the life of the enemy, he said, I will make you wealthy. In other words, I tie your prosperity to wisdom. I tie wisdom with a rope, and with wisdom, you pull your prosperity. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 12, he said, I, wisdom, I dwell with prudence, and I find out knowledge of witty invention. Proverbs 4, verse 7, wisdom is the principal thing. In all thy getting, get understanding. Am I speaking here? Wisdom has made men to discover great secrets. The wealthiest, the fourth richest man in the world is called Mark Zuckerberg. He is 31 years. He's the founder of Facebook. He's worth $50 billion. He's 31. He discovered that at the age of 19. Eh? What was the wisdom? Check every man. Who's the wealthiest man now? Currently, is Bill Gates. He's worth over $62 billion. What is the wisdom they discovered? They understood that when plenty people contribute insignificant amount, it becomes big. Some of you go on Facebook and say it's free. It's not free. You pay, but you don't know. The money is insignificant. It might be less than a naira. Anytime you enter Facebook, money enters his pocket. Now they have acquired WhatsApp. He has acquired WhatsApp company. Anytime you enter WhatsApp, some of you say WhatsApp is free. It's not free. But you pay, you don't know. They can draw it in cupboard. But they know that when set group of volume of people bring insignificant donations, that's networking. It becomes much. 31 years. You see the arm. The guy is fourth richest man in the world. He found that at the age of 19. Am I talking to somebody here? And they are acquiring more social networks. Wisdom. Listen, poverty thrives on the platform of stupidity. If you are stupid, you can't escape being poor. It has no respect for location. Check where some of those men live. It's in the interiors of American states. Not even the Las Vegas or the Los Angeles or the New York City. Certain interiors. Am I talking here? From here, we are exporting pastors to Asian countries. Our pastor just left for Malaysia 2 days ago. We are exporting pastors to Asian nations from this one time called village that Omega has turned to city. Why? Wisdom. Multiracial ministry, black, white, different people are pastoring under this ministry. How do we relate with them? Wisdom. There are issues I have handled, and pastors, I see them asking themselves, how? Wisdom. I rebuke stupidity from your mind. Poverty problem is mental problem. If you are poor in mind, you must be poor in your bank account. You can't escape it. Mental poverty is the ultimate cause for financial bankruptcy. Can I take that again? How can you be somewhere? No innovation. They gave you a job to work in the bank. That's a job. Go carry suit. Going about with empty suits. There's no innovation, no creativity, nothing. If you employ somebody after 6 months, it's not creative. Either you fire him or you reduce the salary. I was talking to one of my boys working with me, and I was giving him ideas. I said, you know what? This month we'll share your salary. He said, what? I said, I'm teaching you your job. So I will underpay you. When you have somebody who's not creative, there's no stagnancy mentally. If you are not improving, you are reducing. Anybody who's not creative should be fired or underpaid. No matter what you are doing, it's your innovation that gives it beauty. Am I communicating? I told you the biggest nation is not America. It's not Saudi Arabia where you have the oil mines. The biggest nation is not America where you have, where they call them the world's policemen. The biggest nation of the world is the mind. And that is why it is called imagination. Sit down. That thing that makes you stupid in business. Can you see your shop? The way it was. Your shop has become an Orthodox church. 10 years, no painting, no repenting, as it was in the beginning. So shall it be now what? Orthodox church. That's what your shop has turned to. No change, no improvement. When I walk into places, I like new things. I like, if I come to a place 1 year, and if you come to Omega last year, if you came this year, you'll be surprised. That's a place where God is. Every living thing should grow. Be new. If last year you were looking, last month, week you were looking somehow as a girl, you made hair, it was all to the back. You have no money to change your hair. Make it new. Pack some to the side. Same hair, pack some to the side. Pack some. Just look different. Pack some to this other side. Let somebody see you and see that something about you is different. They say, you made a new hair. You say, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. Don't. Just look different. Take some to the front. Take some to the corner. You have no money and you enter the third week. Stand some. Fall down some. Put some at the middle. Just look new. The mercies of God, they are new every morning. What is wisdom in my own terms? Locating God's way of doing things. What is wisdom in my own terms? God's mental prescription for earthly dominance. What is wisdom in my own terms? God's mental prescription for earthly dominance, to dominate on the earth. There are three kinds of wisdom I'd like us to consider in James chapter 3 verse 15 to 18. The three dimensions of wisdom. Or three kinds of wisdom. James chapter 3, 15 to 18. This wisdom descended not from above, but look at this. It's earthly, it's sensual, it's devilish. For where envy is, strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. But the wisdom that is from above is first pure, peaceable, gentle, easy to be entreated, full of mercy and good works, without partiality and without hypocrisy. So God showed us the three dimensions of wisdom. He said the first one is earthly wisdom, common sense. Common sense is what people think they can run their marriage with, and now they have run out of sense. When you say common sense is your key, then you'll be common. Common sense for common people. As a woman, if your husband must love you, kneel down to greet him, do this. You have knelt down, you're almost a cripple. Yet the man does not value you. That's common sense. Need that 20 times. Good morning, sir. Mm-hmm. That's how he frowns his face like a killer. Mm-hmm. There are men, as soon as they are driving to their house, all their children, some run under the table, some run under the chair. Even the wife runs to the kitchen. She's preparing an emergency meal. The lion of the tribe of the house has come. That's how he frowns. Some men think if they don't shout, they have not announced their presence. Who is in this house? The lion has come. They feel they must shout. Once they shout, they know they are around. Real men are very quiet. They are at home. You may not know they are at home. They are always quiet. But you see a man who has lost, who has a complex issue. Once he comes, who is here? And he likes embarrassing his wife before his children, not knowing he's stupid. Your children love you more when you show their mother love in their presence. But what gives you dignity and value is when you have the wisdom that is not, beyond common sense. So you see the first dimension of wisdom, earthly. Number two, it's a devilish. Devilish. The devilish wisdom is the wisdom you get from reading all kinds of occultic books. 6 and 7 books of Moses. Magical books. Witchcraft books. Devilish wisdom is the wisdom they use in duping people. Have you not seen graduates being duped by occultic wisdom? The man brings out money, washes it from paper, become dollar. He say, hey, he say, go and sell your thing. You see the person running with zeal. As far as he's concerned, what the Lord has done is so marvelous. They are about duping him. He sees it as open door. When you have somebody like that who is about being duped, he says he's scared to talk. And they say, if I talk, I will die. Lays on the person's head. See the blood of Jesus. Someone during the week say, Papa, I need to see you. And when you tell me I need to see you, I may not reply you. Because what can you see me for that you can't tell me on the phone? So he said, I need to see you. I didn't say a word. After a while, he said, okay, they say if I say it, I will die. I say, for saying they say if you say it, you will die. You have already said it, so start talking. Because you started talking already. He said, they say I will die. I said, text me what the matter is. Some people came, they carried paper, they now wash it, they took to one baba. The baba did not have airtime in his phone, but he made a call, the call went through. I started laughing. I said, devilish wisdom. Devilish. He said, they say I should go and bring money. I went, I collected this money, I gave them, and this, when it was true, I said, in the name of Jesus, your mind is restored by the blood. Occultic. Those things they do are not ordinary. Some of those people have occultic backups. That is why I laugh at people who live life without backups. When a politician is harassing you, he's connected to his godfather in politics. He will abuse you and say every kind of thing against you because he knows there's one godfather. You are making noise, harassing people, and nobody's behind you. And your mouth sharp pass for compound. You don't get support. You can't do me anything. You can't do me anything. Tithe, you don't pay. Offering, you don't give. Pastor, you don't respect. You can't do me anything. You can't do me. And you sleep that night, you wake up, your legs swell up. They say, but we thought you were bossy. Whoever did this to me, eh? What God will do in this compound? Upon all your mouth, you'll be running. Only one leg, oh. That one is for teaching practice, oh. They have not started, oh. That one leg is teaching practice. They just give you one leg. That's how you, emergency paralysis. The person that did it to you was the person that prescribed a carpenter that can make crutches. That's how you're working. You cannot hide it from God. This compound, anything people are doing, God is seeing. You were boasting. Am I communicating?
Everyone under narcotic spell in your family, by the blood, their senses are restored.
The gospel is what handles satanic spell.
The gospel is the power of God. I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes. You don't serve a dead God. You serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday. He's the same today. He's the same forever. When God says yes, no man can say no. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. God is on your side. Power is on your side. Glory is on your side. Lift your hand, shout hallelujah.
Three kinds of wisdom. The third wisdom is the wisdom from above. 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 That's the wisdom Solomon operated with. It's the wisdom that dissolves doubts. Wisdom. There is a wisdom that comes from heaven that a woman can have in marriage. All this equality you are claiming, feminine rights, is what has made two teeth miss in your mouth after a blow. Feminine rights, your husband talk, you talk. Your husband talk, you talk. You plan people to monitor him. Check him. Anyway, go, come tell me. You will only have high blood pressure and die. And your husband may not even mourn you for 1 year. 3 months is gone. Why? Because as far as you are concerned, you have wisdom. That's not wisdom. Give yourself peace. A woman that knows what she carries is not intimidated by another woman. Anytime a lady is intimidated, it's a complex problem. Am I talking to somebody? You know what you carry. You are a child of God. I have said this over the years, that if I were a lady or a woman, there is no lady that can connect my husband. Wait till you carry one, no carry. You dress, I dress. You waka, I waka. You catwalk, I elephant walk. There is a virtue a lady will command that when the husband see her, he say everything I want is here. That's how you have become a security woman. Your husband is sleeping at night. You are sneaking. Where your phone? Where your phone? Where your phone? That's the mother of a household. You are sneaking. Where your phone? Your husband too, he's also a criminal. So he kept the phone under the pillow. Person won't want that. He doesn't see one bury him. He kept under a pillow like this. That's why he put his head on top. He put Bible on top. He put another thing on top. He now put pillow. So if you want that phone, you must remove his head, remove the pillow, remove the Bible, remove the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So as you are trying, you are removing the man head and lie. Even in his dream, he's conscious. In his subconscious. That's how you did everything. Finally, you remove his head, you succeed. You remove pillow. As you're removing Bible, God cooperated with him to catch you. That's when the man thought. What did they find? I want to read Bible. Around 1 a.m. 1 a.m. You want to read Bible? Are you having CROK exam? You are trying to. That cannot help you. Now look at the description of the wisdom of God. Peace. Peace. Anytime you are trying a method and it's not giving you peace, it's not the wisdom of God. Because the wisdom of God gives you, I don't know if I'm communicating this morning. The wisdom of God gives you peace, calmness. Anytime you start losing your peace, God is not involved. That's how I've lived my life for years. When my peace is tempered with, I put myself in check. Anytime you start losing your peace, God, how do I get this wisdom? Number one, 2 Timothy 3:15. From a youth, you have known the only scripture that is able to make thee wise. 2 Timothy 3:15. The first key to wisdom is the Holy Scriptures, is the Word of God. If you must be full of this wisdom from above, then you must have the Word inside of you. 2 Timothy 3:15. From a child, thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. So, you get the wisdom of God by the Scriptures. 2 Timothy 1 and verse 5. 2 Timothy 1 and verse 5. That's the second way to appropriating this wisdom. If you read from verse 5, run down to verse 10. You see the Bible say, does anyone lack wisdom? Let him ask of God, who giveth liberally without upbraiding. Prayer. Second key to wisdom is prayer. Number 3, key to wisdom, Proverbs 13 verse 20. Don't forget, the first key to wisdom is what? The Word of God. Second key, Proverbs 13 verse 20. Proverbs 13 verse 20. He that keepeth company, he that walketh with the wise shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. The third key to wisdom is the right company. You cannot move with idiots and not end up idiotic. When monkeys are your friend, banana is your portion. You know, I read a story about a lion that grew up in the midst of lambs. It was a story I read. And the lion began to behave like the lambs. Until one time they went to the riverside and were trying to drink and lap water like a lamb would do. And the lion saw its face in the water. It was a mirror. And something struck his subconscious. And when another lion ran, all the lambs took off. The lion chased them to a point, turned back, came to this lion, smelt it, and was going. This lion went back, that grew up among the lambs, looked at the water again, and ran to the bush with that lion. In other words, this face is what I look like. That's what you must understand. Your company, who is your friend? Who is your friend? Any company that does not inspire you will expire you. Someone came to my house and was telling me about cars. We just got a 2015 Jeep and was talking. So this car just came out, and that was the second time I'm having such a visit. This one came out. There's one Bentley that is even 2017. Can you imagine? We are 2015. I was talking of cars 2 years ahead. I was quiet. I was sitting with one of our pastors. He was talking, all kinds of models. He brought a magazine. He was pointing cars, and I shouted, "In the name of Jesus!" And he shouted, "Amen!" I said, "Shut up." You see what I said? Because this spirit, this atmosphere is devoid of God's presence. And when you come like that, speak in tongues. Let's speak in tongues. People that come to your office, Bakale, Bora, Kelo, Zaga, Dia, Bakoliata, Ikoleraba. Those are friends. Barikote Zakalaba, Likrote Jakato, Brahaka Silarabi. A companion of fools cannot escape destruction. That's what the Bible says. Destruction shall not be your portion. Anyone in your life that is on the pathway to destruction and dragging you along, today by force and by fire, I disconnect you in Jesus' name. If you must travel far, you must travel light. Hallelujah. Can I stop here? Or let's say the virtue, and we'll round up here. Honor. Somebody shout honor. The blood of Jesus, I'll just stop here. The blood of Jesus conveys honor. What is honor? Admiration in awe. What is honor? Dignity. Uncommon respect. Ladies and gentlemen, when you talk of prosperity, why most people love prosperity is not because of the abundance of materialism. Why most people love prosperity is because of the honor that goes with prosperity. If you check most men who God has blessed, they are not materialistic. They can ride any car. They can wear anything. There's no money in their pocket. They are fine. But what they can't stand is somebody walking to them, say, "Give me," and they are not able to give. That disrespect and dishonor. Am I communicating here? With the blood, when you say the blood of Jesus, God looks at you and supplies honor. Anything called shame around you, anything that looks like shame, Kalabasata, may it be exterminated from your life. Proverbs 15 verse 33, before honor, there is humility. Humility is not stupidity. Hello? Because most people think humility is that you just be going like one underprivileged human being. You can be humble and yet esteemed. You didn't get that. Esteem. You are conscious of what God has made you and who God has made you. Humility does not deny reality. Humility is a major key, but I'm trying to explain what humility is. Humility is not living like a Lilliputian, under privilege. When I go anywhere in the world, first world nations or second world nations, I speak with audacity. If you watch a South African program, you see the way I spoke about Nigeria with so much honor. I said, "Don't insult us that we sell drugs." Because that's what they say. That all Nigerians they sell drugs in South Africa. I said to them, Nigerians are selling drugs because you are buying. If you don't want them to sell, stop buying. Oh, Nigerians have collected all the jobs. I said, because you are lazy. I told them, I said, without Nigerians, you'll be poor in this your country. MTN has the biggest market in Nigeria. ShopRite in Lagos alone, they have about 3 or 4 ShopRites. And we can count the ShopRites in South Africa. And Nigerians, when you talk of ShopRite, Nigerians are really shopping right. You see, a man wants to buy a cube of sugar, packet of sugar, ShopRite. What he can get from Aboki, we don't value our things. Am I talking to somebody here? He wants to buy Indomie. Honey. Shortcake. Shortbread. And he walk into ShopRite to buy shortbread and he wore a basket for shortbread. So you can be humble and yet carry esteem. Walk into places with good morning. Now, there's a way you can say good morning, sir, and say it without being stupid. Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. What's that? Good morning, sir. Esteem. When I walk into nations, hey, my step alone. Deliberate. I'm going to be 20,000 Oyibo if I walk at the gather step. With so much consciousness, if it's easy to be black, but it's very easy to be white, so bleach. We are not like the world. That's why I keep saying we do things like the world. Next week now is 14th, right? People are talking of Valentine. No believer celebrates Valentine. If you have a spouse, every day is a day of love. No born again, we are not like the world. No born again Christian will go out and say, you are a Valentine party. You are not born again. Be my va. Ulava. Be my va. Are you my va? Who is my va? A Christian. See what is coming out of your mouth. Va. Be my va. Be my va. Ulava. Ubuzeva. Not born again Christians celebrate Valentine. Check the story of Saint Valentine. There is no Jesus in the content. So if you are here and you attend the Valentine party, whatever happens to you, don't say I didn't advise you. Oh, Papa, are you saying we should not do love to our spouse every day? Every day. Create a special day. Hello? As I'm talking now, some of you already, see your eyes, it just changed now. Because some of you are planning. Hey, Papa, I've just come to spoil show. Go back and tell that man that your pastor say, Valentine's Day, nobody's going anywhere. Pray. As a matter of fact, that's even our anniversary day yourself. So there's no carry one person out. You now sit down every day for your spouse. It's Valentine. Hello. So all of you young ladies who have given bills to young men, I've just ministered deliverance to those men now. Alright, how do we assess honor? Psalm 35:13. Two keys to assessing honor. Psalm 35:13. The book of Psalms, chapter 35, verse 13. But as for me, when they were sick, my clothes was sackcloth. I humbled my soul with fasting and prayers returned to my bosom. Don't forget, humility is the key to honor, and fasting empowers humility. So fasting invariably is a key to honor. Any man who lives a life of fasting attracts the spirit of honor. Anytime you fast, the flesh dies, the spirit is, you know, comes forth, and honor is attracted. John chapter 12, verse 26. This is the second key to honor before I pray with you. John chapter 12, verse 26. If any man serve me, let him follow me. And where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve him, me, him will my Father honor. Service is the second key to honor. What are you doing for God? That's why I told you all the time. I say, if you are not a member of a department, you are proud. It is pride. Service, the key to honor. God has blessed me astronomically in the past few years. Why? My consciousness for the work of God just commands strange blessings. Amazing blessings. We were in Abuja one time, the last program, last 2 weeks, Eagle Square, was it last 2 weeks? Last 2 weeks, the Eagle Square packed out everywhere. And someone came to see me, a politician. He came with a seed in his hand. So I said to them, we had about some senators and some people. Mama was with us there. I said to the man, come in. They let him up. I forgot what he is in one state like that. So he had a seed in his hand. So I said, drop it. And he sat down with him. He saw some of his so-called godfathers. So we're talking. And I was talking to them about the gospel. So I now told them what we spent in the last crusade. As soon as he heard the amount, he carried his money and put in his pocket. I said, well, I said, Papa, let me prepare. I'm not prepared. I said, why? He said, no. I'm intimidated for the gospel. I said, yes. Because we want the gospel to have value when we preach it. So we don't settle for the less. Service. Serve God with your money. Serve God with your time. You know, during church, people look at their time. Oh, Apostle, when is prophecy starting now? Prophesy. Come and prophesy now. I'm seeing some wheelchairs. When are they going to start walking? Round up this message. Honor. You have said honor. You don't do. Pray. They're in a hurry. When you get a 9-to-5 job or 9-to-4 job, what they are paying you for is your time. If you leave before 4, you can be fired. Your time. So you must serve God with your time, serve God with your strength. This place is still under construction. I was told at midnight, the other decorators were still here. Midnight yesterday. Some slept here. Because this place now is almost like, there are lots of work going on. Why? People serving God with their time. With their strength. You are a banker. Say, you know the way our work is. We are very busy, you know. We are busy. From 8 to like, even Saturday we go to work, you know, no time. You are busy counting people's money. But busy, as soon as they lose their job, you see the banker standing on the altar with the letter of termination. Lift him to God. As I live by before you, as a token of my love, holy, holy. And God will look from heaven. He say, you. You will suffer for long. You want to use me? You have no time for God now. And I discover most people have that mentality. If you see a Christian testifying or telling a pastor what God has done for him, he's looking for another one. I'm telling you, daddy, I'm the one that you came, you prayed for, and God gave me a child after, as you prophesied. But daddy, the problem now is that this is my child that God gave. You want another one? If you are not a servant, you need to repent. Why did we have a problem in leadership in Nigeria? We had no servant leaders. People have the consciousness of let me serve. That's why people can buy houses and can't even remember many houses they have abroad. They can't remember. What people steal in 6 months is what some generations can't steal in their lifetime. I'm not saying in the generations. I was asking a young man, I said, come. They say you stole 82 billion. I said, come. I said, your blood pressure, is it normal? He said, very normal. Okay. 82, you sleep, you wake up. He said, yes. You wake up. He said, yes. I said, how do you cope? Look at the revelations coming out now from the arms deal. Blood money. People were dying and other people were chopping. My heart be skip when I hear some of these things. Even though it's overrated, though. Even though it's overrated, politics has entered. But why would such a thing happen at all in a country where people are crying that they are losing loved ones? You are giving young men rifle to go and combat people carrying bomb. Am I communicating? African, most African leaders are not servants. The leadership is not the position. Leadership is the person. Leadership is service. You are a pastor. You are a servant. Not that they don't call you pastor, you're angry. Maybe they call you, your name is James. You say, why are you calling me James? Don't you know I'm pastor? Is pastor your father's name? James is arrogance that refuse. You want title. You want title. You are proud. You're proud. If somebody they give you position in the department as the treasurer. By the time they now call you Joanne, you say, no, call me treasurer. Is that your father's name? He said, don't call me Joanne, call me Tre-Tre. Tre-Tre. So now they call you Tre-Tre. Hey, Tre-Tre. They give you a permanent name for a temporary office. Let's imbibe the spirit of service. That somebody walks to church and he sees place dirty. He's like, where are these sanctuary? No, you are not looking for sanctuary cleaner. It's your duty to clean that place up. Yes, you walk to a place, you see things, you see. I do that a lot. Anytime my wife and I see anybody, we see a deficiency. We are thinking of how to bless. She was telling about somebody, I think I was in South Africa. I said, only there's somebody who is trekking. Let's give the person a car. That was some minister, you know, not in this ministry. I said, when I come back, she said, okay. He said, I'm just taking your permission because I want to do it this week. I said, you are just telling me, let me come back. We are looking for who to bless. Serve God with your money. That Brazilian weave on of how much? How much is it? 70,000. Peruvian, Scubian, $100,000, Indian, $120,000, Morovia, $150,000, Liberia, Ghana. You are carrying an Indian, a Brazilian hair or a Nigerian head, and you expect to be normal. See women hitting their head. But yet, when it's time for offering, you don't give. Stand on your feet. We want to pray a prayer of dedication. Lord, I don't think I have served you enough. I don't think my service is enough. I want to improve. Empower me to improve on my service. There's nothing. Why do I preach the gospel around the world? A lady was about to die at the age of 79. And they asked the lady at 79, she was an evangelist. She had won thousands of souls. They asked her, what's your biggest regret? He said, my biggest regret is that I'm not taking to heaven so much souls like I expect. I have not lived my life in the impacting of souls. I remember, you know, some years back, if we are going for crusades, we have to explain to the church. We are going to social place, try and be a blessing. But today we float crusades in nations as if we are doing open hair. No shake, like no feeling. They say, Papa, that place is so and so amount to I said, is that where all the big musicians use in that country? Say yes. I said, we'll use them. Sir, do you know the price? I said, I don't care. For Jesus, we'll use them. We're in Cameroon. A meeting that broke through CNN. 5 days regular news on CNN. Jam the stadium, jam the grandstands. In Benin, jam Ogbe Stadium, jam the grandstands. Jam the field. Live. The whole newspaper in Cameroon for the 2 days. That was the news. Transport fare increase. So long as you say you are going to stadium, they double the fare. Why? For Jesus. We are in Maryland, America. Security men became traffic warden. The policemen that came, all the white policemen that came became traffic. The whole city blocked. They said the history of that state, they've not seen that crowd. For Jesus. Not for soccer. Not for football. For Jesus. The lady was about to die. And the lady screamed out. And when the lady asked her, what's your biggest regret? He said, not enough souls. And she sang the song, must I go an empty handed? Must I meet my Savior's soul? Not one soul with which to greet him. Must I empty handed go? Must I go an empty handed? Must I meet my Savior's soul? Not one soul with which to greet him. Must I empty handed go? Not in death I shrink or falter, for my Savior saves me now. But to meet him empty handed, thoughts of that now cloud my brow. Must I go an empty hand? Must I meet my Savior's soul? Not one soul with which to greet him. Must I empty hand go? Kakato, I've not given you enough time, Lord. Empower me this season to increase my service. Anytime your output, your returns are questionable, it means your service has an impediment. Oh God, empower me to increase my service. Open your mouth and pray in the Holy Ghost. Empower me until I wear my crown. Until I wear my crown, I will never, never stop my journey halfway.
Until I wear my crown.
Oh Lord, empower me, empower me, empower me. Empower me, empower me. Empower me. Ziggy, 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 ziggy. Zaga to go look at the 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 Zaga to go look at the 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 Zika Bragada 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 In the name of Jesus, I want to release upon someone, as I hear by the Spirit of God, an impartation of spiritual empowerment to be current with the Holy Spirit. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth, not proceeded. Present tense word of God. Lift your hands to heaven. Father, I ask upon your daughters, upon your sons, fresh anointing. Right now. 102 persons. You take this fresh anointing to all that you do. That as this anointing comes upon you, you will enjoy spiritual lifting. Your fellowship with God will be uninterrupted. Right now, in the name of Jesus.
Take it. Take it. Take it. Take. Take it. Ushers, watch out.
Look at people flying everywhere. Don't bring anybody out. Just hold them. Don't bring them out. I ask that this day the power of God comes on you, your service to God. Your service to God. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You are the Lamb upon the throne. If you will, thank you, Lord Jesus. Can I lay my hands on you? Can I lay my hands on you? Pray against setup. All right, pray against setup where you work so they don't set you up for what you don't know about. You begin to go through challenge. For what you do not know about. So you have to pray against setup. Alright? I saw a uniform on your body. I saw a uniform.
Yes, I'm a federal receptive, sir.
On the road?
Yes, sir.
A uniform and you are standing on the road?
Yes, I'm a federal receptive.
Yeah?
Federal receptive, sir.
Federal road safety.
Yes, sir.
Come out. God said I should pray for Linda. God said I should pray for Linda. If your name is Linda, please let me see you. Come out. Wait for me, sir. Come this way. Where are you from? Where? What state are you from?
From Kogi.
Kogi?
Kogi, sir.
Do you know Ochaja?
Yes, sir. We are from Ochaja, sir.
Ochaja?
We're from Ochaja, sir.
You are from Ochaja?
Ochaja, sir.
Come out. Look at me. Who are they to?
My elder brother, sir.
Your elder brother?
My elder brother.
Who is the woman?
The wife, sir.
That, can I pray with you?
Yes, sir.
I saw an operation.
Yes, sir.
I saw that they booked.
Yes, sir.
Can
to pray? India, sir.
Can I pray? Everything is wrong. If I look at the body, everything, you talk about the heart. Talk about the heart problem. That she has a heart problem.
Yes.
And they say they want to do a surgery.
Yes.
This is not a heart problem.
Okay.
It's not a heart problem, okay? She will not need to go to India.
Amen.
Do you know people are being referred from India here? They refer people here. So you spend your money on something else, madam. Compassionate Jesus,
how I love you. Compassionate Jesus,
how I need you.
How I need
your feelings for me.
Your feelings for me
makes me fall in love with you.
Makes me fall in love.
You know, I could have asked, do we have any of the doctors here? I left Dr. Abraham in South Africa. Do you have any of the doctors? Mostly. I want to lay my hands on our heart, let them go and scan it. Woman, you have the report. We have this place. We have a strong healing anointing here. So we have a place that's like clinic. The HIV test, if I pray for you, they just take you there, they test you. That's what we're doing now. So I'm going to lay my hands on her. They'll take her straight and scan her. Now. We have seen that severally here. Father, in the name of Jesus, we curse the affliction to go. Brand new hearts. Healed. Healed. To your glory, our heart and every fiber of our body is healed. Healed. Stand up, you're free. Let doctor take her. Let them take one. No, this way. Let the doctor take her this way to the clinic. Let them go and examine her. Give God praise. Sit down. Ole barata salaka. Father, we thank you. Your feelings for me. I cannot say no.
Carry me alone.
Who has Uche in the names? You have a name. They call you Uche. They call you Uche. They call you Uche. They call you Uche. Okay, all the Uches come. No, Uche is the last name. Your name or your last name? Your name. Sit down. Your last name. Your last name. Uche. Who is that coming? the last name or your name. Go. Soporuchuku. What's your name?
Soporuchuku.
Soporuchuku. Uche. Yes, sir. That's your name.
Yes, sir.
What's your little name? Huh? Uche. My first child is called God's favor. You remove God's favor. What's your name?
Favor.
Be careful. Sit down there. Be careful. Come. What class are these? Are these medicated guys? Medicated? Or recommended?
It's medicated.
You like it?
No, sir.
What does it do? Short side, long side, average side?
Don't know.
You don't know?
I'm
they just gave
eye problem.
Eye yes. problem. What do they call the eye problem?
Don't know.
You don't know? Okay. So what do I, if I want to pray concerning the eye, what do I pray about? What do I mention? I would just say eye problem. When they gave you the glasses, what did they say it's for?
I've forgotten. It's been long.
It's been long they gave you?
Yes, sir.
All right, come. You don't have a job. You don't have a job. Because you were working somewhere, but you lost your job.
Huh? Yes, sir.
If you enter this year, if it goes further, it will be 2 years. Because this thing happened 2014. And I need to pray with you for a better job to come. You are not with your husband?
Sir?
You are not with your husband?
Yes, sir.
You are not with him?
Yes, sir.
Are you divorced or you are separated?
Divorced.
In court?
No, sir.
Have you gone to court?
No, sir.
You can't be divorced until he's in court. Okay. I saw something in the realm of the spirit that I want to pray about. Can I talk about it?
Yes,
I saw something in the realm of the spirit. I saw a man. Why are you crying? I saw a man who both of you were together. Yeah?
Yes.
You're married.
Yes.
And you kept wondering and praying about a child. You wanted a child.
Yes.
But the man said he doesn't want a child.
Yes.
You say you want a child. He said you must not have a child.
Yes.
You said, man, I want a child. The man said in this house you must not have a child.
Yes.
He said he doesn't want a child.
Yes.
Because it belonged to something.
Yes,
and in that thing, there was something that you should not have a child.
Yes,
this is a great message.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
You are correct, sir.
And there was, they said, don't have a child. You say you want a child. They said, don't have a child. And people started asking you, why are you not pregnant? Why don't you want a child? You don't know how to tell them that your husband says he doesn't want a child. Do you know sometimes both of you will quarrel, beating, eh? Because of that issue. Because you say you want child. He said he doesn't want child.
Yes,
you will thank God for your life. Because there was a woman he was married to before. The woman died.
Yes,
he told that woman, no child. The woman was stubborn. She got pregnant and gave birth to a girl. Is it true?
Yes,
a girl. And the woman died. So he keep telling you, don't you know her? It's your sister. Come. God of the mountains is still God of the valley. When things go wrong,
when things go wrong,
He makes it right.
He will make it right.
The good time,
God of the good time.
He's the God in the bad time.
He's the God in the bad time.
God of the day,
God of the day.
He's the God in the night. You know Enugu.
I'm from Enugu.
The place is like Ugbo.
Ugbo. Ugbo, yes, sir.
What's that? Is that your village?
Ugbo.
It's your village.
His Come. Village. His village.
Come. Yeah. I saw a corpse. Go and lie on that altar and just thank God that you are alive. That's all I'll tell you. That's all. Thank God for life. Come. You are the sister, right? How come? Hey, if I say this now. I saw something in the realm of the spirit. It's a crime for a younger one, for younger ones to be getting fulfilled and elder one is stagnant. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
I pray today that the yoke that is making you appear as a figurehead breaks in Jesus' name. Then I wait for me at the altar. You have a testimony. Hey.
Yeah. I was born to win. I was born to win.
I am not defeated. What I wanna say,
I will always win.
Whatever comes my way,
I will always win.
Yeah.
I was born to win.
Take your seat.
Shout Jesus!
Please, if your name is Zion, can I see your hand up? If somebody is bearing Zion as a name, I don't know what this person has to do with church or ministry. What's your name?
Pastor Zion.
You are a pastor?
Yes, sir.
Come. What do you have to do with Lagos?
Sir?
Do you have anything to do with Lagos?
Yeah, I have a place in Lagos.
You are based in Lagos?
Yeah.
Okay. Your time has come. Stand up. I saw you in the realm of the spirit. Can you hear me? You are going through a state in your life now where you are confused.
Yes,
now at this point, you can't even pray. Because most times when you kneel down to pray, you are clouded with confusion.
Yes, sir.
And
yes,
the confusion, it now breeds an unsettled peace.
Yes, sir.
I saw something in the realm of the spirit. I saw you in a man's house. You were married.
Yes, sir.
But you left the house.
Yes, sir.
You left this man. This man has something to do with ministry. I don't know.
Yes, sir. He's a pastor too.
He's a pastor.
Yes, sir.
You left the man's house.
Yes, sir.
And, you know, there's an anointing upon your life.
Yes, sir.
When you pray, things happen.
Yes, sir.
And people love you.
Yes, sir.
A lot.
Yes, sir.
But you left this man's house. Several things happen. One of the things that happen is, this man, when he gets angry, his temper is bad.
Yes, sir.
He will beat you.
Yes, sir.
Kick you.
Yes, sir.
He has a very terrible temper.
Yes, sir.
And most of the things he will beat you for are very minor things.
Yes, sir.
When you both are talking, he doesn't let you talk. You say, shh, pam,
yes,
beating.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Now, this man made his family, when they get married, is a problem.
Yes, sir.
To keep their marriage is a problem.
Yes, sir.
And most times when you left, you started saying, his family was bad. His family was bad. What about your family? If you say his family is bad, what about your own family? Because you know some of your friends, some ladies, They deceived you. There were certain things they told you that were not true. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
If you say this man's family is bad, what of your family? Do you know what happened when you were born?
No.
There was an idol.
Yeah, but
they dedicated you to. Your father was a herbalist.
He's a native doctor.
Your father loved you. Who is this?
This is my mother.
Okay, let her come. Let me ask her. Does she hear me? Mommy. Agatha. Mama, what's your name?
Not my name.
Agatha. Chica. Chica. Agatha Chica.
Yes, sir.
That's her name. Mama, when the Bonham, when the Bonham, your guy, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four wife.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. You.
Yes, sir.
Do you hear me? Number 3.
Yes, sir.
She's number 3.
Yes, sir.
The husband, 4.
Yes, sir.
When the bond is speaking, your guy, he dedicate this speaking. Say, if this one grow, you will come to serve. You see?
I say it's not my portion.
your father didn't say so. Your father didn't say it's not your portion. You are the one saying so. We have to say so. Because when you come from a foundation, you cannot set yourself free. No. When you come from a foundation of power or bondage, you cannot pray for yourself. People from that family cannot pray for you. It has to be somebody from another family. That's why Jesus sent 2 disciples to the town. One was from that town, the other was not from the town. Reuben was under a curse, and the men of men, Reuben, began to diminish until Moses came and said, let Reuben live and not die. He reversed the curse. It was a curse that was older than Moses. But there was an anointing that was older than the curse. Oh, yeah. Who is wealth?
My sister.
Wealth.
Yeah, she's a pastor too.
Who is Uche?
Uche.
Yeah, Uche. What number are you in the family?
Sir.
Are you the last?
Yes, I'm the last.
Wait, you guys were 7. You guys were 7. But I'm not seeing one alive.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Remaining 6.
Yes.
Who is Ego?
She's dead. She's dead.
That's the one?
Yeah, the first daughter.
One Kego.
Yeah.
What's this? Nchambo. There's somebody I'm seeing. Nchambo. There's somebody. Incha. That's our name.
Yeah.
Our name. Incha.
Yeah.
Who is blessing? Blessing.
Yeah, my daughter.
It's your daughter too. Mama is sick. Mama is not well. Mama, you know your liver. Eh? There's a problem with your liver and your blood pressure. All this side, you're in pain, down to your legs. The enemies want to give you a stroke, but the power of the devil is broken!
Amen!
Tap that lady that's sleeping. That lady that's sleeping. Let her come. Bianule, vive tu come re. Gana mie a ekele, agana si a ibera. Bianule, vive tu come re. Gana mie a ekele, agana si a ibera. Imela tineke, imela nyewe, imela. Yeah.
Wait.
Doctor, what? Have you done it? You've done the test? If your God is dead, try my own.
Yeah, Papa, this is a miracle. A wonderful one. She actually came with a medical report of mitral valve stenosis, enlargement of the heart.
Mitral what?
Mitral valve stenosis, one of the valves in the heart.
You people have too many names. You call literal what?
Sir, there are four valves in the heart that in the heart that control the pumping of blood. One of the valves is actually narrowed. Blood cannot pass through, and thereby she gets dizzy. She cannot walk from here to there. She cannot make a sentence without actually losing her breath. Sir, examining her now, the apex beat is in the normal position, which shows the enlargement of the heart has gone back to its position, sir.
Are you just looking like that? Give God praise, everybody.
And sir, she was able to walk from here down to Jehovah the doctor without stopping on the way to catch a breath. Normally, she would take two steps and be breathless. And then she walked with us all that way and didn't stop to take a rest. That's a miracle, sir.
Sir, you are supposed to rejoice. Sir,
God has given your family a miracle, and this is how you people call the husband. Excuse me, call the husband. God has given your wife a miracle, and you are normal. If I were you, I would lose my mind, jump, scream, shout, faint, collapse, stand again. Huh? You're happy?
I'm very happy. I have the joy. My heart is full of joy. I'm very, very happy.
What
I feel like walking on my head.
Lift your hands and give God praise.
When there's no one to help me, you will not remember me. I will not still be.
Let mama come.
Love of my life, Savior of my soul, the Holy One of Israel, you died on the cross just to set me free. You are my Ololufe, you are the one I am. Love of my life, Savior of my soul, the Holy One of Israel, you died on the cross just to set me free. You are my only one for me. You are the one I adore. You are my only one for me. The only one for me. The one that gives me peace. The God that sets me free. When there's no one to help me, you alone remembers me. The family in times of me. That's what I will let you be.
Love of my life, Savior of my soul, the Holy One of Israel. You died on the cross just to set me free. All alone for me, you're the one I adore. Love of my life, Savior of my soul.
Sets me free when there's no one to help me. You alone remembers me. Care for me, thanks of me.
is what I will let you do. Oh Lord, you fed me. My God, you alone will be my God. Oh Lord, you fed me.
You know, people are wondering, with my busy schedule, how can I still write songs? It's the Spirit of God. I saw our elder. You follow your wife too now. You know, in the church, we have so many bind and loose songs. There are no love songs. All right? So we need love songs in church. Take your seat. Who is Peter? Ogba. Peter, Ogba. Is there somebody like that? Peter, Ogba. If that's your name, please come. Mommy, come. Can I pray with you?
Yes, sir.
Your time has come. Can we get a chair for her?
I said I'm on the locator.
Is that? If I what?
Daughter.
If you are a daughter, then you must be located. Okay, now you are located. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise.
Father, thank you. Moti solo roko bati alisa.
What is this like? Please, Mama, hear something like Irem. Irem. Grace, Irem. Let her just stay there. Do you love Jesus? Please, don't worry, we're going to the next service, Jehovah the Doctor. There'll be miracles, signs.
You are great, yes, you are. Holy One. You walked upon the sea, you raised the dead. You reign in majesty, mighty God.
Everything written about you
is great.
You are great, yes you are.
You are great. What a mighty God is there.
is great, and that greatness will manifest in your life. Take your seat in the name of Jesus. God bless you. We are wasting time, right? Last Sunday, I saw a woman that was 77. And I told her, I saw a woman that was 77. And we have a car. I told her, we'll get her. Wait. I told her, we'll get her a car and a driver for the rest of her life. And we're doing that. And we are also setting aside $50,000 for the maintenance of the car every month for the rest of her life. Where is Mama? Where's Mama? Where's Mama? 77 years and still strong. She's even running out. Mama, come. Mama. Sure. Then there is another. Where is Pastor Sai? There's a car for Pastor Sai outside also.